All right, so our goal is going to be to try to create learning algorithms that are not quite as smart as you were in that example, but you know, trying to approximate that, getting as far along the you know, rock to Charles continuum as we possibly can.
Okay, we want algorithms that are Charles complete.
No, I think you're probably still going to beat the algorithms that we're going to talk about in this class. But someday, someday. All right. So the important thing is that we have to figure out what it is that we are trying to learn. So in this case, what we're trying to learn is a behavior. We're trying to learn a way of interacting with the environment that obtains high reward. And it turns out that there's different ways to think about this depending on what kind of behavior you are looking for. So one classical kind of behavior that is very common in the AI literature is the notion of a plan. So a plan usually refers to a fixed sequence of actions. So the kind of thing that says, okay, I see where I am now. This is the sequence of things I'm going to do. I'm going to go left, right, up, 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 down, pick up, left, left, down, 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 drop off, something like that. So that plan, once you've chosen the plan, you can just execute it. It's just that fixed sequence of actions. And this happens sometimes in real life. You know, there's certain kinds of behaviors that we just have memorized as a sequence. But in fact, what's a problem with this? Why can't we, in general, just execute plans in order to satisfy the kind of goals that we're trying to satisfy?
Well, so I'll say two things. One is I was actually executing a plan once I figured out what was going on, right?
Yeah, that's true. All right, so there's part of it is during learning, you don't know stuff, so you don't know what kind of plan to execute. For this slide, I'm talking about behavior structures for after learning. So during learning, all sorts of weird things have to happen. You have to try stuff out, you have to adapt. But once you've figured out what you want to do, you could try to represent it as a plan. But the problem with that, okay, so it is true. The environment that I showed you has a property that makes plans actually okay.
Yeah, it's deterministic for one thing. So that was the second thing I was going to say, which is that the plan worked because everything did as I expected it to do. It was deterministic.
Good. And so in stochastic environments, you need to be at least a little bit of aware of your surroundings. You need to move around with your eyes open. And so one step in that direction is something called a conditional plan. So you can think of a conditional plan as actually being a kind of program where a plan is a fixed program where it just executes a sequence of statements. A conditional plan can have if statements in it. You can sort of see what's happening in your environment. I'm going to do this, this, and this, and this. And if I get to this point and such is true, then I'll go this way and start these actions. Otherwise, I'll try these things and these actions.
Right. So could one of your if things be, if everything works out the way I expected, keep going? If it ever doesn't, then stop and try to figure out a new plan?
Usually that's not thought of that way. A conditional plan would be something where you have that sequence and then there's a branch point. You know, we ask a question and we could, you know, if everything's gone okay, continue the way we've been going. But if not, then a conditional plan has an else statement, right? It tells you what you should do in case that that's not true or in case that something else is true.
Okay.
What you're talking about is something more akin to dynamic replanning, where the idea is exactly what you said. We're just going to continue along the plan, making predictions about what's supposed to happen next. If those predictions are violated, we just generate a new plan. So there's nothing in the plan that says, here's what I do in case things break. Instead, we wait for something to break, and then we react to it.
Okay, fair enough. So that's just-in-time conditional planning.
Just-in-time planning, really. Because the conditionals aren't in there.
Fair enough. I like that.